What's up, guys? It is Trey Lesio, the Dawn of Entertainment, back with the Pop Culture Dinner Tray. All you need to know in music, movies, TV, and sports, your ultimate entertainment news reel. Let's eat. Movies and TV. During an interview with BBC Radio 1, Kendrick Lamar was asked about the possibility of landing a cameo in Black Panther 2. He said, "Come on, I got to now." When asked what the ideal role would be, Lamar said he'd be down to play a Killmonger-type character that's a villain but loved and misunderstood. Kendrick Lamar and TDE curated the album for the box office hit Black Panther, so it could definitely be feasible for this to come to fruition. Nothing has been set in stone yet, but we will keep you posted as always. Mark Hamill has expressed interest in joining the cast of Guardians of the Galaxy 3, and director James Gunn seems to like the idea. A fan tweeted at Gunn asking if he'd find a role for Hamill, and Gunn responded, "I think Mark Hamill lives right around the corner from me in Malibu, so he can just come over and we can talk about it over a cup of coffee." Hamill himself then tweeted at Gunn, "I would be happy to do so, both as a good neighbor and as an unemployed actor." Wink, wink, spoiler alert, remember the ending of Star Wars The Last Jedi? Hamill later told Gunn to direct message him for his contact information, so the ball could be rolling here. According to The Hollywood Reporter, Paul King, the director of Paddington, is in the final stages of negotiations to direct a new Willy Wonka movie. Plot details have not emerged, but the screenplay is being written by Simon Rich, the creator of Man Seeking Woman and a former Saturday Night Live writer. Although Charlie and the Chocolate Factory with Johnny Depp was met with mixed reviews, Paddington 2 sits at 100% on Rotten Tomatoes and was dubbed as the best reviewed movie in Rotten Tomatoes history. So expectations are pretty high for King to produce a classic here. Sylvester Stallone shared this picture on Instagram. It appears to be the first poster for Creed 2. It also appears to confirm Dolph Lundgren, aka Ivan Drago, will be back, possibly to train Michael B. Jordan's Adonis Creed in the upcoming sequel. Creed 2 is set to hit theaters on November 18th this year. According to Variety, Jessica Chastain is in talks to star in the It movie sequel as the adult version of Beverly. Sources stress that negotiations are early and the script is still being worked on, but both parties have begun discussing Chastain for the upcoming project. No word on any other actors for the other adult version of the kids from the original movie. It, too, will be coming to theaters on September 6, 2019. Chris Tucker went on ESPN's podcast, The Plug, and said a fourth installment of the Rush Hour series is happening. Tucker said it's going to be a rush of all rushes. Jackie is ready, and we want to do this so that people don't forget it. Tucker, however, did not say when the movie will start production or hit theaters.
Hut hut, sports.
Sources have said FBI wiretaps intercepted Arizona head men's basketball coach Sean Miller and Christian Dawkins discussing a payment of $100,000 to ensure star freshman DeAndre Ayton would sign with Arizona. After the report broke, Miller did not coach against Oregon. Ladies and gentlemen, the house may be coming down for the NCAA. More to come. Stay tuned. Closing ceremonies for the 2018 Winter Olympics took place yesterday. Norway finished with 39 medals for the highest total. Germany came in second with 31 total medals. Both Norway and Germany tied for most gold medals with 14 apiece. Canada finished third with 29 total medals, and the United States finished fourth with 23 total medals. The NCAA vacated Louisville men's basketball wins from 2011 to 2015, including the 2013 national championship, following multiple NCAA violations. All this comes after NCAA found out that former Louisville head coach Rick Pitino failed to properly monitor the actions of Andre McGee, who arranged prostitutes, stripteases, and other sexual acts for potential recruits as an assistant on the coaching staff. Team LeBron beat Team Steph 148-145 in the NBA All-Star Game. LeBron James won the MVP award with 29 points. Donovan Mitchell won the dunk contest, and Devin Booker won the three-point contest. Music. Logic dropped a new song, 44 More, the follow-up to 44 Bars from the mixtape Bobby Tarantino. This has led to speculation as to whether this song will be from a new upcoming album, a potential Bobby Tarantino sequel mixtape, or if it's just going to be a Lucy song. Logic said he recorded the song last summer while on tour. We'll keep you posted on any new developments. Lil Yachty announced the release date for his upcoming project, Lil Boat 2. The mixtape album will drop on March 9th. Drake's song, God's Plan, has become the second song to ever get 100 million streams in a week. This comes after the release of the heartwarming video where Drake gives almost $1 million away to needy families in the Miami area. For the fifth week in a row, God's Plan sits atop the Billboard Hot 100, and now the song sits next to Harlem Shake in the history books. 2013's Harlem Shake is the only other song to hit over 1 million streams in 1 week. Dessert. Notable movies coming out this Friday, March 2nd, include Red Sparrow and Death Wish. Notable albums coming out this Friday, March 2nd, include Memories Don't Die by Tory Lanez and Planet by Tech N9ne. I'm Trey Alessio, the Dawn of Entertainment. You are watching the Pop Culture Dinner Tray, your ultimate newsreel for entertainment, everything you need to know in music, movies, TV, and sports. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel. Please like us and follow us on all the social medias. We have some merch coming. We have more content coming, more articles, more videos, more. So stay tuned, subscribe, tell your friends to hop on the bandwagon. You know the drill. More podcasts coming. Be sure to listen, and we will be back for more. Again, I'm Trey Alessio, the Dawn of Entertainment. Thank you for watching, and